After Virgon buried their nukes, the leaders of the 12 colonies promised we would never see war of that scale again. Peace would reign in our lifetime and the lifetimes of our children. They could not have predicted the Cylon Rebellion less than 30 years later. The worst conflict in colonial history, and we are at a stalemate. No foothold gained that isn't lost again within weeks. The Jupiter Project was supposed to be our ace in the hole, the largest, most powerful battle stars ever created. Each of the 12 colonies were promised one in return for signing the Articles of Colonization. The first, Galactica, was Caprica's crowning glory. It went missing 2 weeks after deployment. Athena, the fifth ship to be completed, belongs to PyCon. We were days away from delivering it when we heard the news. PyCon's capital cities were devastated by Cylon assault fleets. Among them, our own colonial fleet headquarters. There was no chance to intervene. Command of colonial fleet has fallen to Rear Admiral Kane. Our mobile shipyard, Daedalus, has become the ad hoc fleet headquarters. As Kane's XO aboard Daedalus, you have been promoted to Operations Commander of the entire Colonial Fleet. Kane intends immediate retaliation for the attack on PyCon. The War Room awaits your arrival, Commander. PyCon's Battlestar is almost ready to deliver, but Sinan says it can't make an independent jump until the fuel lines have stabilized. Kane's orders are to jump Daedalus to PyCon with the Battlestar Athena attached ASAP. That means we have to clear the scouts here or risk telegraphing our movements to the entire Cylon fleet. I'll prep the deck crews for the jump while you deal with the toasters. Good hunting, Commander.
Make our presence known in this war, Commander. I trust you won't need my instruction twice. Tell your ships to move full speed towards the enemy. Proceed when you're confident with your commands.
On it, Commander. Yes, Commander.
Our ships use fire control systems to automatically target and fire on any hostiles that move within range. Turrets will be less accurate the smaller or further away their target is. You can access a ship's fire control and check on its firing solutions for yourself.
Thank you.
We've got a new Dreadus contact. Dreadus IFF confirms the contact is a Cylon Corvette. Scanning for further intelligence.
These Cylon Corvettes won't hold up to sustained fire. Focus your turrets on one side to punch through their armor and destroy the hull. These ships also have long-range guided munitions, useful for softening a target before closing in for the kill.
Missile tubes prepped.
Your ships don't seem to be performing as well as they should. They may have system damage that's been overlooked.
Understood.
Tell the engineering crews aboard those ships to hotfix what they can. I'll see to their comprehensive repair once you've finished with your engagement.
System repairs underway. System repairs are complete. Understood. Firing solutions updated. Manticore is taking damage. Yes, sir. Understood. Yes, Commander. Daedalus is taking damage. Yes, sir. So say we all. Thank you. All hostile contacts are down. We recorded a vid feed of the battle if the commander would like to replay the fleet's performance. Congratulations, Commander. But we still have work to do. Kane has got her stomping boots on. Started shelling out orders before she'd even finished sticking the admiral pin to her jacket. She's out to prove she's ready for the top job of Colonial Fleet. Can't feel good to earn that promotion off the back of your superior's bad luck. But we've all lost someone in this war, I guess. My sister was on Galactica before it disappeared. Pycon's government is blaming Kane for not delivering Athena earlier. Both she and Sinan won't be happy until we've delivered all 12 of the Jupiters to the colonies. Well, at least we'll get to see Athena clear out some toasters before we hand her over to PyCon. Daedalus is ready to jump on your command, sir. Our ships took a few hits during that fight. We should have the crew do some repairs before we move on. Prepare to jump in 3, 2, 1. Jump complete. Dratus contacts bearing 017, Carum 021.
PyCon and the rest of the 12 colonies are watching our every move, Commander. Some would see Colonial Fleet fail. Ensure we succeed.
No pressure, sir. No pressure at all. Yes, sir. On it, Commander.
Ships are not lifeless assets to needlessly throw at the enemy, Commander. Adjust a ship's posture to tailor the crew's tactics so that you can match whatever opposition you encounter. A defensive posture ensures the ship's defense-oriented subsystems are more efficient. Likewise, an aggressive posture will boost the ship's offensive capabilities at the expense of the ship's defenses.
Emergency cruiser on standby. Firing solutions updated. Commander, receiving word from Athena's CAG. Their alert Vipers are online and ready to return hostilities. Understood. Brace for impact! All hands on deck! Hostile unit identified. Missiles incoming!
Use squadrons to hit priority targets or defend any of our own capitals. You can recall a squadron back to its carrier if the situation begins to deteriorate.
hostile. Squadron target is confirmed. Yes, Commander. Yes, Commander. Fighter squadron is taking fire. Yes, Commander. Commander, I've asked Sinan if there is any way we can stop those Cylon tech ships from hacking our systems, but he's being stubborn.
We've already minimized onboard networking. Your firewall should keep them out for a while. Otherwise, take the subsystem offline for repairs if they cause too much damage.
Or you can rely on the tried and tested method of shooting the Cylons down before they get the chance. Battlestars are equipped to accommodate flak ammunition. Use this to zone out fighters and incoming munitions.
Understood. Incoming! Yes, sir. Manticore is taking damage. Sir, PyCon Intel just confirmed that Admiral McKennelly died in the attack on Fleet HQ. With Admiral Sarkis still missing aboard Galactica, Admiral Kane remains the commanding officer of Colonial Fleet.
McKennelly was a good commander and a good soldier. We honor his memory today. So say we all.
So say we all. Yes, sir. Yes, Commander. Yes, sir. So say we all. Manticore is taking damage. Yes, sir. Understood. Yes, sir. Understood. Missiles on their way. Thank you. On it, Commander. This is cold. All hostile contacts are cleared.
If you're finished playing with PyCon's toy, I believe it's time to hand Athena over to their defense ministry.
They've already been notified, Sinan. Commander, there's something else. We're having some difficulty with Daedalus's navigation computers. It'll be easier to explain from the war room. Admiral, Commander, we have a problem. The Idris relay that we use to outsource our jump calculations is malfunctioning.
Malfunctioning? What's our effective jump distance?
It's difficult to estimate with just the onboard computers. The red line extends beyond Helios Alpha, but we'd probably need an intermediary jump to get anywhere significant outside of the system.
This is what an ambush looks like, Commander. Find us a way back to Helios Gamma immediately. I want Daedalus under the cover of Ragnar's clouds before the Cylons can attack.
Commander, we're going to need more ships. Sinan's taken up yards 1 and 2 for the Jupiter-class Battlestars, and we're only prepped to crunch Manticores right now.
The floor crews are changing their build priorities as we speak. There's no use having a half-built Battlestars if we can't defend them.